Hey everyone, welcome back to my channel. So today in this video, we will have a very common yet simple React interview question, that is the search filter. So as you can see, we have the fruit search filter where we have a list of fruit items. So in this, if a user starts typing, let's say if a user writes AP, then the fruit items which have this AP as a substring will be displayed. And let's say if a user writes something that is not present, then the user will be shown a message that is no fruits found. So how to have such functionality? So let's dive into our code straight away. So I already have the CSS as well as the list of fruit items. So let's just quickly have the layout for this. And let me import my CSS as well. And let us also import our fruit items. So simply a curly brace with fruits from our items. And let's give this a class name as simply filter container. And let's just quickly have the heading that is fruit search filter. So first thing first, we need to have an input field where a user can type the query. So to have that, whatever the user writes, we need to have an input field simply of type text. So whatever the user will write will be displayed there or will be searched. And we will have on change event handler. What we can do, we can simply write the function here, that is handle change, and define the function here separately. Or instead of writing that much code, we can simply So we'll simply use arrow function and update the value here only. So to store whatever the user will write, we need a state variable. So simply we need to use state hook. Then simply let's have a state variable as searched query and the function which will update the value of this state variable will be set searched query, and this would be an empty string initially. So instead of writing the function separately, we will update the value of this state variable here only with the help of this function. So simply, and how to grab whatever the user will write, simply by using the event object. So event, and here only event dot target dot value simply, and value would be the same thing or state variable that is searched query. And let's have the placeholder as simply type to search fruits. So now we have our input field. So let's check we are getting the thing or not, whatever the user are writing. Let me just console log and show you. So simply our search query. So let's check to see whatever the user is writing, we are getting it here, right? So we achieve the first thing. Then we need to create our filter logic. So for that, I'll be using filter method. So what the filter method does, it creates a new array with the element that will pass certain condition that we will provide. So our condition here would be simply we will compare whatever the user will write, that is the search query, with this root items. So that would be our condition. If that condition is being passed, then filter method will create a new array with those elements. So let's have that. So let's say the variable name is simply filtered items, then simply fruits dot filter, and our arrow function, and whatever I will write here, let's say item, then our whole list of fruit items will get stored here in this item. So simply our condition would be item dot includes, we will use this method, and simply our search query. So what is the use of this? What this include method does is, so let's say if a user writes AP simply, then the include method will look for that substring AP. Let's say the user write AP, then it will look for this AP substring. And what do we mean by substring? So as you can see, substring is basically a contiguous part of a string, and there must be no gaps between them. So it means if a user writes AP, then it will look for continuous AP. As here we have AP, and here also we have AP, here also we have AP. So it will return apple, grapes and papaya. And let's say if a user writes LE, then it will look for this substring LE. So here also we have continuous LE with no gaps. And then here in lemon, LE. So it will return again the apple and this time lemon. So this include method will search for the substring the user will write in this items, list of fruit items. And whichever item passes this condition, filter method will create a new array containing those items. And to avoid case sensitivity, it means if a user writes capital AP, or maybe if we have the fruit items as capital, so there will be confusion of uppercase and lowercase. So that can harm our logic, filter logic. So to avoid this, we can simply have item dot to lowercase, then includes, and here also search query dot to lowercase. So now, irrespective of our fruit items are in uppercase or maybe lowercase, and here also whatever the user writes in uppercase or lowercase doesn't matter. All of them will get converted to lowercase or will be checked with the help of this includes method. So we have our filtered logic ready. Now we need to show that. Show the list of items, right? So to show that, simply we will use the map method, which will create an array of fruit items for us. So simply IUL, and then we will have filtered items, and here also we will check if filtered item dot length is greater than 0, then we will show the list of fruit items. So don't worry about this condition, this I will explain. So if this is true, then only we will show the fruit items. In the else part, we will have no fruits found. And simply with a class name as no results. And in the true part, it means if the length is greater than 0, then simply we need to display the fruit items, right? So we will use the map method this time. Simply the filtered items dot map. And here also we will have the first parameter as item, then second ID. And here also the list of fruit items will get stored in this item. So here also simply li with ID equal to simply, sorry, with key equal to ID, and here simply the item. So let's check. So we have our search filter. So let's say the user types AP, then the include method will look for the substring in the list of fruit items. So whichever fruit item is containing this AP is displaying that. And again for LE, and let's say XC, to see it shows no fruit found. So how it works? So initially, when we have empty string, then for empty string, this include method will return true. It means initially, when nothing has been typed, the string is empty. Then for empty string, includes will return true and display all the fruit items initially. So initially, all the fruit items is displayed, and as soon as user types something, then this onChange event handler comes into play, and then it will look for this AP substring. And here in our filter logic, as soon as the user types, it checks for this condition, and then the filter method will create a new array which will have the elements that passes this condition, right? Then here in this part, we have conditionally shown the list of fruit items. It means filtered items dot length is greater than 0. So initially we have all the fruit items, so the length is definitely greater than 0. So all the fruit items are being displayed. And let's say again AP, then we have 3 fruit items. Then again the length is not equal to 0. Then again the list of fruit items shown which matches as these are shown. And let's say if the user types something that is not present. So that time as XC is not present, it will fail this condition, and the filter method will create a new array with empty elements. It means this condition is being failed, it will not have any element. So this time this condition fails, like filtered items dot length is not greater than 0. That time it would be simply 0. So the true part will not be shown, and simply the false part, that is this no fruit found, is being shown. So see, so this is how you can achieve your search filter logic. Yes, that's it for this video. Hope you understood this in a much better way. So see you all in the next one. Till then, take care.